Hello everyone, welcome back to No Man's Sky. This is my third video. This is the first video, though, the day after release and the day after I read all the comments. Anyway, just going to touch on this real quick, you guys. All you guys that know me, all you guys that are part of the Meathead Nation, thank you guys. I'm glad you're enjoying the game. New games come out, we're going to get some visitors from people who don't know who I am, who call me an idiot because I do blind playthroughs of games, because I don't spend countless hours in the closet studying trailers and reading texts and going through the encyclopedia of the game before it even releases. Look, I like to enjoy the game as I go. I understand sometimes it can be frustrating, but when you're doing stuff, like when I'm doing stuff like this, you know, I'm not looking that my bolt caster needs to be charged because I'm trying to learn the game. So I've done a little bit of fast forwarding, basically. I've gone to a couple other planets just to kind of check out the game. That way, when I come back in, you know, I know a little bit more. I did get this. Look at this thing. So I found this guy in like a place like this. It was just on a random, I don't know if say random planet. I'll show you. There's what I visited. This is what I visited. I just basically cruised around, renamed some systems, renamed some planets. Didn't do anything special. Didn't do anything other than the fact, like, this was the first place we went to. This was the second place we went to, I believe, JoJo and Red Rock, right? I don't know if it was on Red Rock or if it was on one of these two where I found this gun. Or gun, it's the mining and bolt caster. So where I found it was like in a place like this. This is where you get upgrades for your mining tool. I think it might have been in a space station. It was in a space station. So it was on the wall like that, right? It was on the wall like this, except it was like a rectangular panel. It folded down. There was a mining tool in there, like this one, multi-tool, that's what they call it, multi-tool, and it has 8 slots. My original one had, I think, 6 slots. I did find one other one that had maybe 6 slots as well. It was just a different shape than the original, but this one here had 8 slots, and it had all this stuff here. It had all of this stuff except for, I believe, this one. The beam, yeah, all except for this. And I already had that from my other gun. When I bought it, was like 54,000 credits. And it just took away my other one. But everything that was in there, in the other one, I was able to remake if I didn't have it on this one. So that's pretty cool. Now, the only major thing before we get going, I want to just get out of here and go visit another planet. I just came down here, actually, to hit a save point because I didn't know how to save. There's no way to exit the game. You just close the application. So I saved, closed application, came in just now, a day later. It's literally almost to the hour. It's 10 o'clock at night the next night. It released 9 o'clock at night 24 hours ago. So I came in here, I hit that save point there, and I just closed application. When I came back in, it brought me right back to that spot right there. So that's the little beacon there. Every time you go to one of these things, they'll have like a little save beacon. So that's pretty cool. Now, the one thing I have not tried was looking back in this menu, like it shows all these things here. Rename, upload, view. Okay, so there was one planet that I found that I, at the time, like right now, it says you lost connection to online services. You see that? It did this last night, and I wasn't able to rename the thing or something. So one of these, though, I was able to, let's view this one. I was able to find gold on it, right? I found gold. Oh, it's only going to show this stuff. I thought maybe it would show the resources on it. There was one I found gold. I was going to name the planet Gold or something like that to let me know that there was gold there. It was the first time I had seen gold, but I couldn't do that. And then I found another planet that I found aluminium or aluminum. That was pretty cool. Now, one last thing before we get started or get going. what my, you know, the little missions that pop up in the bottom right corner? So one of my missions was to refuel the hyperdrive with a warp cell. Now, I had to go build a warp cell by going to a space station and actually buying, I had to buy antimatter, okay? And I bought it. It's pretty expensive to buy it. So I bought antimatter, and I made a warp cell and then warped to another planet. In doing so, I found that there's actually a warp drive upgrade that I'm going to need to actually travel farther away, because I've tried to go farther away and it said, you need upgraded warp drive. Now, then my next mission was to go find like a blueprint, a research document, so you can actually make this stuff called suspension fluid. And with suspension fluid, you can then make this electron vapor. And with electron vapor, you can make antimatter. And with that, you can then make a warp cell to refuel your hyperdrive, which is pretty cool. So there was one other blueprint I found, and I don't remember what it was, but it wasn't actually important. So the other thing I found out was I do have a nice, a different, like a mining blaster on this, like a plasma, I think it is. All right, let's just get out into, let's get out into space. And then, I don't know if they added something from last night, but when I just came in here, I found out there's a lamp. Like a headlamp. It said push up for headlamp. So if you look at this, now look, I have a phase beam and a photon cannon. I was using the photon cannon, but look at this phase beam. It's pretty cool. It just, like, destroys these things, man. Now the thing that I'm, the thing that I'm having issues with now is inventory space. I'm running out of inventory space on my suit and my spacecraft pretty quick. I think that is the space station right there. All right, so we'll go cruise over to the space station real quick. I'll show you guys. Engage pulse drive. Cruise over there. So I've been doing a few things just so, I mean, I didn't want to be a total noob and have you guys cringe. I hate when people say that. Figure out your own words. Don't copy the internet. That's boring. Don't be unoriginal. Unoriginal's dumb. Anyway, figured I'd try and, you know, mess around with it a little bit. Try and get a little bit going on here. So one of my next big goals, I was so lucky. Those of you that know me know I, you know, blue, indigo blue, kind of electric blue is a color that I like. And this ship has got a cool, like, blue stripe and stuff on it, which is cool. So I really like my ship, but I keep meeting these aliens at like these different, now actually, I don't know if you're supposed to do that, but I actually hit the brakes when I get close, I actually hit the brakes. I think I'm gonna slam into this bad boy. I've been to this space station, I believe. Whenever I go into a new solar, lately, when I go into a new solar system, I've been going into the space stations. So, I like right here, watch, when I go in here, there might be another ship coming. You can go up to the ship, like I did in last video, and actually try and purchase it. And I saw, they're kind of big and ugly, but I would imagine they have a ton of cargo space on them, right? The one I looked at, we get a restore point when you get in here, too. But look at my ship. It looks pretty good with the blue. Almost looks like a Star Wars, like an X-Wing, just without the X-Wings, right? I think it's awesome. Dominash S84. I wish I could change the name on this, but I didn't see anywhere where I could change the name. All right, we'll go up here and see if I actually put on extended on my suit. I'll show you this. So on my exosuit, the one thing I added was this. I was able to build this stamina enhancement. Now, the other thing was I'm in a new area where it's a different, like, species of aliens. The last areas that I was in for a few of these systems. Does it say what the race is? No. Anyway, these here were the same race, and I actually got up pretty decent on the. Here comes a ship. I got up pretty decent on my credibility with them. So I was able to get stuff from them for cheaper or interact with them, you know, different things like that. Look at that! Look at that ship. So the ship I looked at was a little bit bigger looking than this. They wanted 1.5 million credits for it. Let's see how much this guy wants for his ship. So you go in here, you interact with it. It's see, these are the guys, these Vikings. Vikin? Whatever that is. These are the aliens that are here. The other ones were wearing suits. Anyway, make an offer to this lifeform starship. He wants 1 million. So 1.02864. And I have 192,000. So, but look at what you see here. Oh my gosh! 22 slots, you guys. Look at that. Oh, dude. 22 slots. This is my ship. It's even got some blue on it. So that's a Dabashil S25. So the goal now is to work toward, obviously, collecting credits. And somewhere along the line, I'm sure I can upgrade. I think I did upgrade once my exosuit to get one more slot. I did get an exosuit upgrade to 13 slots, I believe. I'm pretty sure I did. So these are some of the things I'm trying to get. Because, look, I like not investigating what the game... I hear the hype. I say, okay, there's hype. You know, I like Mike Slate, you know, is telling me, dude, No Man's Sky, check it out. One of the Meathead Nation. You guys are awesome. So what I do is go in there and play it. Now that I'm in about my third video and I've got about 2 hours into the game or so... Hi. How's it going? You have bad breath. I'm just saying. Let's talk to him. See what he has to say. So some of these things I found are like almost like tricks. If you do the wrong thing, it'll take stuff from you. Oh, see, he wants my multi-tool. The warrior looks at me with fire in his eyes. The species is clearly aggressive, and I doubt I'm welcome. Yet the lifeform bows in greeting. Tradition and honor perhaps dictated. I don't feel I'm in imminent danger. I am about to turn and leave when the creature points towards my multi-tool and barks with concern and makes a motion to suggest I should hand it over. No. The warrior respects my decision. Thank goodness. So my standing just increased, okay? So my standing is increasing with these guys, but that other race of aliens, it was up, getting up pretty high. It was getting up pretty high. So you can interact with these different devices. Some will maximize your shield. Some will restore your health to max. One thing that I forgot to look up, that I wanted to actually look something up, was Atlas passes. Every single door I go to says you need an Atlas pass V1, V2, and now I'm up to actually V3. And I don't know how to do these. I did make some of this stuff. Show you this. I was able to make these bypass chips. Okay, I made bypass chips to get past some of these, whatchamacallit. To get past, there was like, you land on the planet and there's a beacon. And the beacon, if you go with a bypass ship, it'll tell you where the monolith is, where maybe a space station, not a space station, but like an abandoned beacon, abandoned factory is. And you just make these bypass chips to do it. All right, let's see if maybe suspension fluid, bypass chip, warp cell. So these are things, see, these two things are things that I make a lot of, I guess. I make a lot of bypass chips and warp cells, and then curiosity. Okay. Anyway, I need to figure out like what the deal with these Atlas passes are, because I'm missing out on a lot of stuff not having this Atlas pass. And I don't know, all right, let's analyze their multi-tool. Anytime you come across one of these, make sure you check it, because it usually will unlock some new technology for you. New technology, once you get it, you can make it at any time when you have the right equipment. So this is like new tech, right? So if you look, I have a coolant network, Theta, on here. health, protection, utilities. I have some different ones that I can actually put on here, but I'm already so limited on space, all right? I'm so limited on space. But every time you come across these, make sure you check them out because it'll give you new tech. And then this is like the little galactic trade terminal that you can check out whenever you come to a space station. And some of those things, like where we started this video, some of those buildings will have terminals in them where you can do some trading as well. So let's see if we need to sell anything. You know, this power canister is just taking up spot. Watch. That's going to be like the next thing that I need. So I got carbon, aluminum. I'm going to sell the aluminum right now. And platinum, zinc, titanium. Sell the titanium. And the Gek charm. So I found multiples of these Gek charms, and I found these like pearls and stuff. Good luck charm carried by many galactic traders. Okay, well, I'm sure there's some background to it. Like, you should hold on to this, right? But for right now, I'm gonna sell them because I am trying to actually build up my cash. These things, I don't know. They seem. I only have 29 of them for 8,100. I found these on that first planet. So the good thing is, if you remember where you found some stuff, there's the gold that I found. And I thought I had some aluminum, but I must have. Yeah, I just sold it. All right, here's more titanium. Found yellow crystal cluster. You watch. I'm going to need this stuff that I'm selling. I'm going to keep this. I'm going to keep the suspension fluid. All right, let's get out of here. I don't know if I can actually. Let's see if we can actually make. Go to the starship. All right, so we have some suspension fluid already. So if we go to craft. This is the next thing we need to do. So plutonium. Do I have plutonium in my exosuit? No. Yeah, platinum. No, I don't. Plutonium is that you're gonna find there's a few things that you're always gonna need, right? So right now I have enough to hyperdrive out with my thing, but it's usually good. It's only about a quarter full. It's probably good for one blast, which means I'm gonna have to find that stuff before I hyperdrive again. So we're gonna go, let's go to another galaxy just to check it out. Here we go, people. So like I was saying when I was walking in there, what I'm trying to figure out now is, all right, so we go down on the D-pad. All right, we get into this area here. All right, so right now it says path towards waypoint. Now, I don't know why there's a waypoint. Is that? Oh, that might have been just where I marked. Free exploration mode. And then here's path towards galactic core. So let's deselect this. This says. Okay, so the path towards the galactic core is actually. Is it telling us to go here? We see those. Oh yeah, it is. Like, you follow this line. See that right there? Too far to jump. Upgrade my warp drive. So one thing you can do is actually go to the core. We can go here. This has three planets, one moon. Yeah, let's go here. We'll engage warp to this place. For right now, maybe I'll just start following that path to kind of see where it leads us. I can always go into free exploration mode, which is what I've been doing. I may have flown the opposite direction that I really needed to. I did see I caught a little bit of a podcast from the developers, and they were talking about, you know, you can do whatever you want, but there is like a goal if you want to get to the center. And that's what it is, following that Atlas path to the center. Maybe we'll just, instead of randomly picking stars, we'll see what this does. Maybe it's going to give us, you know, more like missions to kind of complete. See, we're still in the Euclid galaxy, which is kind of interesting. We haven't left this galaxy yet. All right, journey milestone accomplished. Let's see, we can actually do warp five times. So I've warped five times. That means five different systems. All right. I think we can actually see what's around here. Is there a space station here? Yep, it's right there. All right, arrive in 3 minutes. Let's see. Wow, these rocks are actually purple. Thaumium. Okay, it's just because the rocks are a different color. Let's switch to our phase beam. I really like this phase beam, man. It is crazy. It's an iron one. We need to go down and get some plutonium. Alright. Thaumium's always good because that's what we recharge. We can recharge our pulse drive with. We can also recharge our tools with. Oh, iridium. Have I got iridium before? Milk this iridium a little bit before we go in the space station. Then from the space station, we'll just head down to one of the planets. Because what I'm looking at is, it's like, every planet I go to, if it's not telling me something in the bottom right corner, say, hey, you know, go find... What the weirdest thing was, it said, go find the blueprint to make the suspension fluid so you can make your own warp cells. Well, it just happened to be right there at the closest planet, so I think that's, like, part of the game. Let me see if this other thing does any better. Yeah, that stuff's pretty weak, I guess. All right, let's go over here. Hey! Coming in hot! There's also another one where it says when you upgrade your warp drive or something, you can, or your pulse drive, you can actually steer a little bit better while engaged. Right now, it's like once you engage those things, you're kind of on a course wherever it's taking you. So I kind of aim my cursor at where I want to go and then just engage. And then if I start going off course, I'll disengage. We'll go see if these are different types of life forms in here. So see, there's a lot of stuff in there. There's one thing over there, but that's behind one of those Atlas Pass doors, which I will look up. After this, whatever I do, I might do one, maybe two videos tonight, I don't know. I will look up the Atlas Pass and see, figure out what the heck is going on, because I've missed out on a lot of doors, a lot of looting, because I haven't had that. Oh, look, it's a different life form. This might be one of the original life forms. Let's see what they are. Sounds different. Hard to tell. All right, let's look around. There's a terminal to trade with. We've got not a whole lot. Let's see what Atlas Pass this needs. The last one was version 3. This is version 3. Okay. I don't see any, like, tool upgrades or anything in here. Here's a device. Let's see what this device does. Health. Okay. Remember I said there's health and shield devices? You'll find those things, like, on the tables down on the planets, too. So it's good to go check those out if you need... Did I just... Am I going to actually sit down? Interesting. Hey, bud. You gonna be mad at me or what? We'll look at the bottom left. Okay, there you go. Corvax. So these Corvax guys are actually the original ones I was dealing with. My level is Traveler of the Atlas. Okay? So that's, you know, I don't know, a couple steps up, meaning I'm in good standings with these guys. Okay, a sharp metal needle emerges from the palm of the lifeform's hand. It moves so fast that it's ready inches from my forehead before I can even blink. A strange toxic-looking goop dribbles down from its point and onto my visor. It hangs in the air above me while the entity waits for the order to plunge it deep into my brain. Refuse the brain excavation, allow the brain excavation, or take the needle. What do we do? Take the needle? The needle's made of silica products. The entity is disappointed. Dang it! Okay, so I needed to let him poke me in the head, I guess. So we can talk to him again by giving him 20 carbon. So always keep carbon on you. See what he says now. Sometimes when you go back in, it says he'll heal you or he'll maximize your shield. All right, so we can request units. Healing, or a new word. Now, as you learn the words, that's how you actually increase your standing with the people. Going to those monoliths and stuff down the planets, reading them, learning their words. All right, let's learn a new word. See what's up. Maybe we can get some of... Oh, he agrees to help. All right, I just learned the word for traveler. Let's go in here again. Give him 20 more carbon. Again, keep carbon, plutonium, stuff like that, because it's useful. I feel bright, piercing gaze, electronic life form. Healing. Okay, so now I can't request a gift. Request healing. Shield, Corvac, point of interest, or above. So what it's saying, those are the levels. I'm traveler, there's point of interest and test subject. I'll just, whatever, just shield recharge. And I think that's, like, pretty much it. If you... I'll talk to him one more time, see if it does anything else. I think it'll say heal at this point. I've kind of exhausted my options with this guy. Healing. Oh, new word. No, I haven't exhausted him. All right, give me a new word there, bud. Probability. Try one more time. If I can keep learning words from this dude, I get above Traveler of the Atlas, and they might be like, wow, that meaty guy, he's worth it. He is totally worth it. All right, shield recharge healing. Request fuel. Really? Interesting. What kind of fuel are you going to give me? Carbon. Wow, I'm giving him carbon and he just gave me carbon back. Might as well talk to him again. See if we can cheese this and get some more words. New word. Thank you. Don't mind if I do. He's, like, so happy to help. Please. I'd learn the word for please. Dude, you gotta rank me up. How many more words do I need, bud? Traveler of the Atlas. Lifeform of the Church. Request isotope? Healing? Okay, give me the isotope. Interesting. What is it? More... just more carbon. Like, I'm giving him 20 carbon. He's giving me back way more than I've given him. I don't understand your language. I need more words. Yes. Thank you. All right, this will be the last one. We're going to go to a planet. Okay, word for hi. All right, nice. I wonder if like this is the idea that you're supposed to continue to talk to these guys. And I'm learning more words than I am. I think I would learn like three to four words per planet. The download over it down grades its communication channels. Okay, so I think that's it. I've exhausted my resource. You can actually take this stuff, get some carbon back from his plants. Like, if you don't have enough carbon, get a couple plants and then talk to him if you forget to keep your target. Journey milestone accomplished. What did we get? Tell me we ranked up in these guys. Familiar, met 10 aliens. Hi, aliens. I'm Meaty. What's your name? Oh, we got two. Whoa, look at that thing. Oh, that kind of looks like Boba Fett's ship, doesn't it? See how much this guy wants for his ship. That looks like Boba Fett's ship. All right, what do you got there, bud? How much? I'm not going to buy it because it's ugly as sin. Let's see how much he wants for it, though. Oh, see? 19 slots, only 500K. That's not bad. And then he's got phase beam, proton cannon, deflector shield. He's got pulse engine, hyperdrive, launch thrust, coolant. This stuff here is all stuff that I don't have. All of these four things here. And I think phase coolant too. So that's pretty cool. 500K. It's not... Oh, that other ship. Look at that thing. Looks like a drill bit. The front of this ship here? Look at the front of this ship. This is like the ship I was looking at, except it was orange. Mathematician Entity Alzama. It looked like this, except it was orange. Let's take a look at this. That was the one that was like 1.5 million. Curious to see how much this ship is. It's kind of interesting. You got to find your own way. Like, I want to, you know, eventually get a new ship. So I'm going to keep checking out these ships and just see what's up with them. 21 slots and he wants 853. So that last one we saw, I think that other system was it this one? I don't know which one it was. Anyway, the system we were just at was farther out, more advanced, because their ships, the ship that I checked there was 22 slots, and that's an ugly one. You know, if you're going to buy a ship, that's pretty ugly, dude. It looks like a flying toaster, dude. I'd rename this thing the Flying Toaster. Remember flying toasters on Windows? Oh my gosh. That's old school. All right, what do we got? How much? All right, a mil. 22 slots, though. See, that's the next ship I want. A 22-slot ship. That's what I want. Let's head off to... The weird thing is it's not giving me... It's not telling me anything. Like, down at the bottom. Like, it's not giving me... Journey. So this is the stuff I've got so far. 22 milestones. Whoop, whoop! Of course, I look at it right at 22. Next milestone, Kepler in 3 milestones. Kasani, Novice, Destroy. Oh, I actually got in a fight. I forgot. Two of these noobs attacked me, and I owned them. I owned them with my phase cannons. Like, what? Yeah. I actually, at first I was trying to fly with them and behind them, and then I just hit the brakes and stood in one spot and waited for them to come after me. Yeah, a couple of noobs. Like these guys. These guys might... Whoa, okay. That guy just flew right through me. All right, do we have... Can I do a planetary scan here, bud? Abandoned building detected. All right, where is that? The abandoned buildings and abandoned factories are really good, because that's where I got the... That's where I got... I'm just looking around here. We got this thing. I think this... It's on this one here, huh? Wait. Whoa. Don't use the right stick. Just use the left stick. There it is. We'll go down here. We'll go down to this abandoned building. Check it out. So, it was an abandoned factory, okay, is where I found these blueprints, like, to get the warp... To be able to make the warp cells. This is going to take too long. Engaging pulse drive. Go! So, you want to go after those if you see them. And I'm going to show you guys, like, just a few of the things that I learned. Like, right now, I'm going towards this thing here. Now, it'll take you out of pulse drive when you go into the atmosphere because of the planetary interference. And then you can go right back into your regular pulse drive, which is R2 and circle. All right. So some of these planets, I found one drain. It was a pretty decent planet, but it drained my suit really, really fast. Like, really fast. Not, it wasn't radioactive. It wasn't toxic. But it was, whatever it was just draining the heck out of my suit. I just thought maybe I was playing too long. And then I got out of there, and it was the planet. For some reason, there was something about it that just drained the heck out of my suit. I'm going to show you guys, like I said, what I learned to find these buildings. So we'll go to this abandoned building, and what we'll look for is one of these beacons. And when we find these beacons, it'll, we can go there, they make up one of those bypass chips and see what's around. The idea is to basically clear the whole planet and investigate all the life forms, and then you're going to get, like, max credits. You'll get a lot of credits, but you could spend a ton of time, which I may have to do. I may have to find a planet, you know, one of these planets that maybe it's a cool planet to hang out on and do that. Try and max credit that planet out. That way I can get up to, you know, I'm gonna need like 2 million credits so I can get the ship that I really want, which is a 22-slot ship. Who wouldn't want a 22-slot ship? We're going to land down here. And then we'll probably come back next episode to see what's going on. Oh, I may be on the building or just past it. Sometimes I've actually couldn't land in some areas. And some areas were harsh winds, passive sentinels, and a lot of flora, which is good. Oh, we land on the right side. The other thing, quickly, is the door. On the abandoned... Some of these abandoned, like, factories, you actually have to use your bolt caster to bust open the door, it'll tell you. And when you do that, it launches sentinels out. But when you kill the sentinels, you get titanium. You also get these cool chips that you can sell and actually make some pretty good coin. So if you want to go after, if you want to go after these sentinels, it's not bad for money wise, you know. All right, so you can see here's the beacon right here. Not the beacon, but this is like the save point. So you can come over here. That's a beacon right there. All right, that right over there is a beacon just over the hill, looks like. So we'll hit this save point. And then I recommend always renaming the places, the planets, the animals, everything, because you get credits for that. Why not rename them? Now, I found that I run out of names pretty quickly. For example, we're here, right? So I would go in here and rename. And then I would just like do the first three or four letters, like G-U-T-U, right? G-U-T-U. And then that's it. I just renamed that planet, right? And then like this one here, call it Vorny. Vorny? With a Y. Like horny, except Vorny. So I just got credits for that. So if you look at this planet here, it says upload and receive 225,000 credits if you get all the waypoints discovered, but you also have to get all of the animals and or monoliths discovered too, which that right there could actually take a lot of time. You know, you have to do this, and if you get the increased scanner like this, you can zoom in. I've got a 3x zoom on my scanner. I believe it is... I think it's this one. Range boost, scanner companion unit. So I'm able to actually range in. So I zoom and then go one. That's one, two, and three. It's the third one. So that's pretty cool. All right, guys, we're going to come back next episode. I'm going to wait right here. We'll investigate around this planet, see if we can come up with some cool stuff. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. I will see you next time.